This episode of Techzilla Bytes is brought to you by LG G3. Welcome to Techzilla Bytes, feed your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and welcome to the LG G3 Android app pick of the week. Smartphones, I bet it's going to sound familiar when I say my phone goes everywhere with me. It's my navigation and tunes in the car, my first stop to check email, web in the morning. I read, I watch videos at night, and night is kind of a problem, at least if the room is dark. Cell phone and tablet screens are brutal on your eyes. If you're reading or watching a video in a plane or in bed, with the lights off, it can be distracting in the car if you're driving at night. Boom, whoa, hey, changing direction and staring at my too bright phone. And that's with the brightness on the phone turned all the way down. Not being able to turn the brightness down anymore sucks. Aha, fortunately there's an app for that. 13 apps at least that I've found in the Android store. Let's take a look at some of the most popular. First up, Haxer Industries Screen Filter, my personal favorite and probably the most popular app for dimming your screen on Android. It's super simple, which is a good thing. Download, install, hit the screen filter icon, and a shade gets applied to the screen of your phone. You pick the brightness, mine's usually set to 30%, and hey, the screen gets dim. My wife doesn't get woken up by the light from the phone. I'm not blind inside the car if the nav app is running and my eyes don't hurt. Very cool, very free, though the creators would love for you to donate to Wikipedia on their behalf. Just watch that you don't make the screen totally black. You're going to need to reboot your phone if you do that. Urbanoid Team's Twilight takes a very different approach. You're not just dimming the screen more, you're tuning it for healthy sleep. Because hey, quote, recent research indicates that exposure to blue light before sleep may distort your natural circadian rhythm and cause inability to fall asleep. So maybe staring at a stupid bright white blue screen before bed isn't too smart, which is probably why color temperature is the first setting in Twilight. You can also adjust intensity and of course dim the screen. It's a lot like the F.Lux Windows app that automatically tweaks your window screen colors based on the time of day. Mostly because by default, Twilight boots with your phone and automatically deploys based on local sunset and sunrise times. Hit the preview button and you'll see that at sunset, the screen fades to a fairly red color temperature of 1500K and an intensity of 40%. Up the intensity to say 99% and you realize the color temp is a filter over your screen. You can customize most of the settings. I mostly played around with the falling asleep friendly bed reading mode, which dims the screen to 55%, drops the intensity to 50%, and drops the color temp to 1000K, which is way redder than daylight. Not my favorite for viewing video, but great for reading. By the way, you're checking out these dimming apps. Got four more to go on our sponsor's flagship, the LG G3. It packs quad HD into a 5.5-inch screen. That's 538 pixels per inch. We're talking gorgeous detail here. Up front, the 13-megapixel camera has laser autofocus. That's never been done on a phone before, and I gotta say it, I love the knock code. Tap 3 or 8 times, and your phone unlocks. Now, another popular screen dimmer is night mode. Very similar to screen filter with one major exception. Click on night mode and there's a big start button above a slider for brightness level. Very convenient if your lighting levels change a lot, but an extra click if you only dim the screen when the lights go completely out. Screen dimmer takes the basic brightness filter you've seen in screen filter and night mode and adds the ability to schedule when the screen dims. That's pretty cool. Darker is another one that works a lot like screen filter. Click on the icon and your screen dims, but darker also lets you choose a color filter, gives the option of leaving the status bar at full brightness, and there's an experimental feature, you can dim capacitive button lights. There's also a $2.99 pro version that adds auto on, auto off, start at boost, a dangerously low brightness below 20% tool, custom filter colors, and more. Now, if you want an even slicker interface, take a look at Vito Cassisi's Lux Light and Lux Auto Brightness. Obviously, some love for F.Lux here. Lux Light uses the light sensor on your phone to automatically adjust to the brightness of the room you're in, and night mode is going to warm the display in darker rooms. There's even an astronomer mode. The presets are good, and Lux offers a novel or maybe overly complicated interface to adjust the presets to your liking. I can't quite decide which. If you want the screen to automatically dim at sunset, that's going to cost you $3.80 for the full auto brightness version. My favorite, still screen filter, though the color filters in darker and twilight are super tempting. One quick warning, pro tip here, running 6 dimming apps simultaneously can make it really hard to brighten your screen back up if you forget which one of them is still running. So do me a favor, pick one, comment down below, or tweet at Techzilla. I'm Patrick Norton. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Techzilla Bytes, and have yourself a great day.